Hey guys, let's do some Rats by Reaper. Here's a sneak peek, see what the end result is. And of course, here is the N Prime Minis. You can see that they come in a row of three, which I think is pretty cool. Reaper Bones series, no Prime needed. We're going to start off with Mountain Stone, which is a pretty good base coat for these Reaper Bones models. I want you to really watch at the consistency of the paint. See how it's kind of liquidy, then it's really stringy. I left this in to show you an example of when things go wrong. You'll see here in a second. Go ahead and start putting the base coat, and all of a sudden, oh my God, it's not covering. What is this? See how it's just kind of, it's yuck. It doesn't have a nice clean coverage. It's kind of glooping up only in the shadows like a wash. Well, the reason why is the bottle was not shaken correctly. Reaper paints are very famously known to have a lot of medium in it. This medium, if not shaken up properly and mixing with the pigment, is going to give you poor results, as we can see here. I'm actually making matters worse by trying to put it on even thicker. Again, a pretty good example of what not to do. So if you're ever painting with these and all of a sudden you kind of see this, just scratch it. I'm applying some alcohol here, isopropyl alcohol, and just wiping it off with a paper towel, and I'm going to remove that horribly mixed, improperly mixed paint from the rat. You can see I'm kind of having, trying to get in the cracks there. I'm not getting it all out. So I believe I'm coming back with a brush. I did that off camera, a brush with alcohol. Now you can see the paint coming out a bit more normal. And we had properly shaken it. You're going to see this time that it's going to go on the way that it should. Using the thumb palette. All right. So now it's covering properly. And I am putting it on thick. But remember with the Reaper Bones, your first coat, your base coat, because there is no prime or primer applied, you're going to have to apply it a little thick. And it will shrink down some. You'll get a feel for it. I'm going to go ahead and do the base right while we're at it. As a matter of fact, since this particular model stand came with three rats, we're just going to paint them all in the Mountain Stone. Speed it up a bit here because you've seen this. And yeah, there's a wet palette in the background. There'll be a future video. And people honestly have done so many videos on wet palettes. You can find all sorts of information. Basically, just keeps your paints wet for a longer period of time. Okay, so now we did our base coat. First thing we grab is a shade or a wash. In this case, we're using the Army Painter Strong Tone. I'm applying a little bit of water to thin it down because I find the Army Painter wash is just a little concentrated. Sometimes they're almost a little too intense. So just grabbing a cheap brush, going to go apply a really quick wash to all these things. Try to get this to fall into the nooks and the crannies. Now, what I'm going to show you here is going back after you lay down your wash, going back with what you call an empty brush. So you just drag your brush on a paper towel, wick out whatever's in it. Go back to the model and basically suck up any of the areas that the wash has accumulated. You can see here there's quite a few areas. I applied the wash extremely liberal, really to emphasize the point, but secondarily because sometimes I just paint sloppy. And when it comes to that first wash, it's guaranteed I'm going to slather it on. Okay, guys, we're going to go ahead and grab some of this Mountain Stone and get started. Mountain Stone. And put some on the palette. Come on now. You can see it does not like to come out of those little tips. Then we grab some Desert Sand. This is going to be a natural highlight. And the beauty of the wet palette is you can kind of lay your paints out ahead of time. Ebony Flesh, this is going to be our darker tone. And this is a technique I'm going to show you guys that I don't use very often. It's called wet blending. And we'll talk more about what that means. But first I need to describe what I'm doing here. I'm putting some drying retarder, a few drops each, into each one of those color samples we drop down. And then we're going to mix it. You can buy retarder from a variety of manufacturers, and basically it just gives you a longer working time of the paint. These are acrylic paints that do dry when they hit the air, so this is going to aid in that. So is the wet palette that we're using today. So you're going to see me go back and forth between these colors, and it's going to seem a lot different than what we normally paint. We usually paint something, allow it to dry, come back. Say we put a base coat, then we come back and put a shade with a wash. Then we come back and we do a dry brush highlight. Now what we're doing is we're actually kind of making the model a palette itself in a way. We're applying different paint, different colors of paints here, these three tones. And we're just working it back and forth and mixing it right on the fly on the model itself. Because we have that retarder in there, it's going to allow us to do that. You can see a little bit of the base tone over the highlight. I'm trying to make a highlight. And I went in through a darker tone down below. And then you just kind of go in and dab and push, touch here, touch there. And what you're trying to get is a transition. So in this case, with this particular rat, I just want it to be a little lighter on top. Get basically the mid-tone through the center section. And down toward the bottom of the model, get something a bit more darker. Now there's some advantages to this technique. One is, you know, you can get a fairly decent blend pretty quick. And I like to show you guys quick techniques. The second advantage is this, just, it's kind of fun. The paint stays workable for quite a long time after you put that retarder in there. And you can just kind of go back and forth and play with it. Now, word of caution, it can also be frustrating. You're not always going to get the result that you want. And it's like anything in life, you have to practice the technique. So I'm showing it to you today, but you don't necessarily have to do it that way. As a matter of fact, as this video progresses, I'm going to show you one of the rats, or maybe even two of them, on this sprue that I'm not going to wet blend. Just to give you some comparison. You can see I'm kind of mixing a tone between the two right there on the palette. Going back in. Trying to get some highlights on there. Then I'm grabbing a mid-tone. I'm kind of trying to mix it right with that highlight. You see how that works? It's pretty quick and easy. And the downside is, like I said, it does take some practice. But not, you don't have to be a pro. I really try to focus my videos to show you guys that a lot of this stuff is, yeah, it's experience, and yeah, you got to get better at it, but it's experimentation. It's just throwing some paint on the model, seeing what it'll do. You know, what's the worst that's going to happen? It's it's not going to look exactly the way you want it. Honestly, boo-hoo. That's going to happen a lot when you paint, man. You just have to learn to live with it or start over, which I don't recommend. So, grabbing a base brush here, and I'm kind of happy with what I have on that center rat in the body, so I'm going to work on the tail here. I grabbed the highest tone and applied it to the tail. Now I grab the darker tones, and I'm just going to try to wet blend that tail. And now I'm grabbing the other rat, doing the same thing, as I like the result. I'm going to try to go with a almost like a skin tone on the tail. While I have it on the brush, I'm going to go in and just kind of touch up the little feet, the nails and the claws, that kind of thing. I'm even hitting the eyeballs a little bit. I'm just kind of sketching in some of the details. And we have to keep in mind that we do have that retarder in there, so at any time I can kind of grab and switch between colors and just change it right on the model. I can either mix it on my palette like I'm doing there, or I can try to wet blend it on the model. That's what we're doing here. Doesn't always work the way you want it. I know with this guy, it just felt like I was applying another base coat. So there's a darker color. We're going to go ahead and try to drop that on the bottom portions and just get the junction where they form. You're going to get a mid-tone between those two colors. That's the concept. And I'm kind of scrubbing it there, right at that junction. Try to get them to mix. Going back to the tail, put a little something on there, a little darkness. That's kind of where we're at so far. We also have to give it some time to dry. I've been using a hair dryer throughout this video to kind of expedite the process so I could sit in one, you know, basic painting session and kind of cover all this. So now we're going to grab some more of that desert stone. And this is a fresh blob of paint because I don't want to put drying retarder in it. And now we're just going to dry brush this other rat here to the left very carefully. These Reaper rats were cool. They're really small though. And the details, as far as texture details, probably weren't as heavy as what you'd want for like an animal. So there was a little too smooth of an area when it's supposed to be fur. So that's really good for a dry brush technique. So I just wanted to show you, you don't have to just stick with, oh, well, he showed me how to do wet blending, so that's what I'm going to do. So wet blend versus dry brush. And it's now dried, and you can see that model on the left with a dry brushed, and then the other two models were wet blended. And you can kind of see the results. The wet blending, or blending in general, it's going to give you a smoother result. The dry brush gives you more of a stark textured appearance. So I'll leave it up to you to decide how you want to do it. I went ahead and grabbed this red to dot in some of the eyeballs. Give these guys a little bit of an evil appearance. Hey, never hesitate to go ahead and just grab your thumb and use it as an eraser. Like here, I dotted the eye and I made a mess. Just rub a little bit and look at that. Now it stays where you kind of wanted it. I did use a smaller brush for this. I believe that's a Series 7 number... No, it's an Isabey number 2, but to be honest, the point's more like a Series 7 number 1 or a 0. So there's the eyes. I wasn't really just kind of going for a little bit of a glow effect by smearing it. Here is... This is basically... It's made by Vallejo. It's called Flesh Wash. Really, it's just kind of a reddy brown wash. And we're going to throw that here on the tail. The idea is the red mixing with the off-white that we put down the tail is going to kind of give us a pink. And that's really what I was kind of going for in the tail. We could have mixed up just a pink color and laid it down, but I just felt like it was going to be way too stark if I did that, and it would look super pink. So tinting the white with a wash is also known as glazing. So it just depends on the technique, and it depends on who's explaining it to you. The two terms can be used interchangeably, quite honestly, and they mean different things to different people. So don't get hung up on techniques too much. That's why watching these videos is really important, because you learn so much more. You learn, you know, the result that someone gets and the application of whatever the name of the technique is. So in this case, we're washing it. We're basically applying a filter to the white color. We're not trying to get it to just fall into the recesses. We want it to really change the original tone or color that we put down. So now we grabbed Army Painter Strong Tone. And I guess I really wasn't happy with some of the darkness and the details, so I went with a darker wash. And we're going to try to add a little bit more darkness here. Now, to be quite honest with you, this rat on the right, man, I really struggled with the tail on this one. I could not get it to look pink and flesh-like like it did in the other two models. Watching the video back, I think I used the wrong color. Not quite sure what happened, but sometimes that just happens. And I've got like 6 more of these little things to paint. I'm not trying to paint an award-winning model. We're trying to build my dungeon denizens, however that's said. So here is an off-white. It's called linen. Or no, excuse me, that was bleached linen. So it's a very bright white. And we're going to mix it in a little bit the previous color. And we're going to go on in, and we can't really do a dry brush here because the details are too small, and it would be very difficult and messy, problematic. We'd probably get the white all over. So we're just basically doing what's called an edge highlight. And we're just going in, trying to bring some focus and we're going to focus these little details. And then we grab some black just to toss it in where I had overpainted. Or no, that was the wash. Here is the black. Toned it down a little bit. We're just going to basically get a darker base coat for the bases themselves. We don't want the model to be exactly the same as the base. You want there to be some differentiation. We're going to pretty much just go straight black. I'm hitting it with the hairdryer. And I left that in there to show you guys because it's a quick way to get your paints to dry. In a painting session, you can get through a model pretty quick. In this case, we got through like 3 models in about an hour. So I'm going back to this desert sand. And I'm just trying to make myself a highlight for that. The base, right? We put down black. So I'm pretty much just mixing my own gray. It's kind of something that's nice about having a wet palette will do for you. It'll give you the confidence to kind of do that. So we're dry brushing here. We're just trying to pick up some of the details of this stone floor. And yeah, sometimes when you dry brush, you mix a color, you realize, hey, it's not quite what I wanted. It wasn't bright enough for me. So we can leave some of that there and go back with a brighter color that I'm mixing. And now you start to see we're just kind of in a few spots here or there that you decide. Just picking out where I think the bright lights are going to fall. And I think that looks pretty decent. I like that. I'm happy with the result. So, yeah, tail woes. So, going back, told you I was having problems with that tail. I decided that I used the wrong color initially. So, I'm going back and basically painting it like an off-white. And I guess the thinking is to go back and do what I did to the other two tails. Sometimes you have to do this. Sometimes you don't get the results you want. You know, and I preach a lot to, like, hey, you know, just, you know, don't stress over it. Don't freak out. And that's what we're doing here. We're just like, okay, cool. I'm just not happy with that result. So let's a do-over. So we're going to paint it white or an off-white, and we're going to try to hit it with that red wash again to simulate the pink. And what I did wrong here is that I used too bright of a white. Where if you go back in the earlier part of the video, you'll see that I used more of a khaki color. That was the desert sand. So you can see the result I'm getting here is really not what the other tails look like. And at the time I was struggling, but I was able to kind of get it close. And here's the final result. Hey, I'm happy with it. They look like rats. They look mean. It's going to go perfect for my Rangers of Shadowdeep missions that I'm playing. And still editing, God help me. So, yeah. What did we learn today? Well, normal stuff. Base coat, wash, dry brush with one of the models. The other ones, we learned how to do some wet blending. And I'm trying to zoom in here to show you the results. You know, take it or leave it. You can see it's a little messy with that left model on the top. It can be quick. Is it quicker than dry brushing? Probably not. There's some objects that are going to be more apt to use this technique. Not sure necessarily that these little tiny rats were one of them. But hey, it was fun. Here's just showing you attack. Yeah, and here's a contrast of like, hey dudes, if you're not happy with it, look at what it looks like when it's not been painted. No matter what your result, it's going to look better than bare models, man. These things look amazing when you compare them to white, bare, ugly plastic. There's no more to say, right? Look at that. I want to let that resonate. Go between the two with your eyes. Yeah. Whereas before, you were staring at it going, it looks okay. It looks all right. Till next time, Killer Minis, Double Pieces, on the way out.